In this video, we will discuss how to prepare for liver resection surgery and what to expect during your hospital stay. Before your surgery, you will have a pre-admission appointment. We will take your thorough medical history during this appointment. Please bring a list of all the medications that you take. Additionally, bring any lung and cardiac tests you may have had prior to your pre-admission appointment. Some medications may increase your risk of bleeding. These include some pain relief medications such as Advil and blood thinner medications like aspirin. Your doctor might ask you to stop these medications a certain number of days before your surgery. Please also tell your surgeon if you are taking herbal medications. The day before surgery, you can eat solid foods until midnight. Afterward, you can have clear fluids until 2 hours before your surgery. Clear fluids include transparent liquids like apple juice, clear jello, and coffee or tea without milk or creamers. Do not have milk or milk products. On the day of surgery, please bring your provincial health card and a list of all your medications to the hospital. Before the surgery starts, the anesthesiologist will provide general anesthesia, which will take about 1.5 hours to prepare. Typically, liver resection surgery lasts between 3 to 5 hours, but in some cases, it may extend to as long as 10 hours. At the end of the surgery, your surgeon will communicate with your family and update them about your condition. You will be taken to the post-anesthesia care unit and remain there until you are stable enough to be transferred to a step-down unit where nurses will closely monitor you for 24 to 48 hours. Finally, you will transition to a regular wardroom on the same unit. There is a visitor's lounge for your family. You will likely still have several tubes and drains in place, including a nasogastric tube for stomach drainage, a Foley catheter to drain urine, a central intravenous IV line, an arterial line, a peripheral IV line, and an epidural catheter in your back for medications. These tubes will be removed within a few days after surgery. You will have some pain from your incision. During the first few days in the hospital, you may have an epidural or a patient-controlled analgesia pump to help with pain. As you progress in your recovery, your need for IV pain medication will decrease. You will be switched to oral pain medications 2 to 3 days after your surgery, once you can drink fluids. During your hospital stay, you will receive a prescription for necessary medications, including pain medications. It's important to review these with your nurse, surgeon, physician's assistant, or pharmacist before leaving. You should also discuss your medications with the family doctor. After a liver resection, the average length of stay in the hospital is about 5 days, but you may be discharged earlier or later. Most people are ready to go home when their pain is manageable on oral medications, they are eating and drinking, they have passed gas through the rectum, they can move around and support themselves safely, and they don't have active medical issues that require hospital care. Most patients leave the hospital with staples still in place. You may be given a staple remover. Please give it to your family doctor or staff at a walk-in clinic to remove your staples. If you have any questions, you are welcome to ask your nurse or surgeon. After the surgery, you will continue to recover at home for a few weeks. In the next video, we will discuss care after your surgery.